Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're going to have a look at the standard takeoff technique inside the Airbus 320. We're using Microsoft Flight Simulator and the Fenix Simulations Airbus 320 model, and we're here on the runway at 07 at London Luton. Obviously, upon entering the runway, you'd want your strobes on, and for takeoff, usually packs off, although we can calculate performance using packs on, but there's a fuel and efficiency and performance improvement with the packs off. Once takeoff clearance is received, we turn the landing lights on and the nose light to take off. So the takeoff technique varies slightly depending on the amount of crosswind or whether there's a tailwind or not. For a crosswind below 20 knots and no tailwind, we'd advance the side stick half forward. So you'll see the indication here. We'd push the side stick forward until we've got the cross in about that position on the primary flight display. If the crosswind's greater than 20 knots or we have a tailwind, we would use full down deflection on takeoff, and between 80 and 100 knots, we would gradually reduce that downward deflection to be neutral by 100 knots. So it does vary between whether there's a crosswind, whether the amount of crosswind. So below 20 knots, half side stick forward. Above 20 knots, or with the presence of a tailwind, full down side stick deflection required. So we've got the CFM engine variant today. Upon takeoff, the pilot flying would announce takeoff. We would advance the throttles to 50% N1 on the CFM variant, so the blue donut will go to that position, as you can see. Or if you've got the IAEs, you'd be using EPR, and you'd advance the throttles to 1.05 EPR. On selection of 50% N1, we would then release the brakes and apply flex or TOGA thrust. Now, the crosswind is greater than 20 knots, or with the tailwind, we'd release the brakes first, and there'd be a more gradual increase in thrust. So we'd go from the fifth, release the brakes, then we'd apply 50% of N1, check for that thrust to be stabilized, and above 15 knots, we'll start to increase the takeoff thrust by 40 knots. The pilot flying will announce the FMAs that would come up here, so it will be the thrust selection, so man flex or man toga, SRS runway for example, auto thrust blue as an example, depending on the situation, the scenario, and the airport you're at. 100 knots, we will announce speed check, so we'll cross check the speed three times, so the first officer will check the speed there, also look on the backup instrument. And this instrument as well. So we do a cross check of the speed at 100 knots. At V1, we would take our hands off the throttle. And on rotate, we'd start pulling back on the side stick gently to achieve a 3 degree a second towards 15 degrees nose up. So once we've established 15 degrees, we then will look for our green bars, which are our SRS commands, and we'll follow the SRS instructions that come up on the primary flight display. Positive climb, which is positive vertical speed indication there, positive altimeter increase, and also radio altimeter increase, which you see here. Once you've got those three things, that's positive climb, and then we put the gear up. Above 100 feet, we can engage the autopilot. At thrust reduction altitude, we move the thrust levers back into lever climb, which engages the auto thrust. Then select packs 1, pack on. And after 10 seconds, we'll select packs 2. And we go through the flap retraction sequence and move into the sort of the climb phase of the flight. On takeoff roll above 130 knots, at 130 knot point, the nose wheel steering disconnects from the rudder pedal, so it's your runway steering is being controlled fully by rudder at 130 knots and beyond increase. So that's important to understand. So I'm going to take you through that process now and conduct the takeoff. So with a C clearance, bit of lights on, axes are off. So we've got crosswinds below 20 knots and no tailwind today, so it's reasonably good conditions. So we'll do a half seismic deflection. Now it's takeoff, and we'll start the chrono as well, so we can monitor our use of takeoff power. On the tow brakes, increasing to 50% N1, and we're looking for stable exhaust gas temperatures, which they are. There. Set takeoff thrust, man flex, 53 SRS runway, auto thrust blue. To 80 knots, and we slightly start reducing the static pressure to be neutral by 100 knots. Check. V1, rotate. Pitching up for 15 degrees. Positive rate, gear up. And then we move to follow the SRS commands. We can put the autopilot on. And we've got lever climb here come up. We just want to ensure we've got a positive speed trend before we engage lever climb. So you can see the nose is dropping slightly as we accelerate. We've now got the positive trend. We can move the thrust levers back to lever climb. Thrust climb, auto thrust. And with that, we'll get PAX 1 on. And the nose and runway turn off lights can come off. And we're approaching flap retraction speed. S speed, speed checks, flaps zero. Flap zero, Chad. And with flap zero, disengage the ground spoilers. And after 10 seconds between PAX 1 and being turned off, we can then turn PAX 2 on. And that's it. That's a standard takeoff technique in the Airbus. There's obviously different procedures, perhaps. So there is for a low visibility takeoff, where the captain generally will be the pilot flying in a low visibility takeoff. A runway visual range of 400 meters or less is considered to be low visibility. TOGA takeoff, TOGA thrust is always required on contaminated runways for takeoff. We can conduct takeoffs in visibility as low as 125 meters if certain lighting is in place at the airport. So in terms of runway edge lights, centerline lights, and so forth. So that's the standard takeoff technique in the Airbus 320. Hope you found that useful. Any questions on that, drop them in chat and I'll do my best to answer them. Please like and subscribe, and if you really want to, please buy me a coffee through the Buy Me Coffee link available in the video description. Thanks for watching.